Police are investigating the shooting deaths of 47-year-old Tara Joseph and 2-year-old Kentrell Joseph of Westall Groupview Fort. The incident took place on the evening of Saturday, April 8th, at the Joseph's family home in Westall Groupview Fort. According to witnesses, the alleged assailants used this chair to prop themselves up to gain access through this window, where they opened fire upon the victims.
I overheard my auntie shout, "Kentrell, I go in and bathe. Stay there." And that was just her last words, and I heard the shots fired. I came, I opened my room door, but I didn't come to the living room one time. Because if I came one time, I would got hurt from that too. So whilst I by my room door, I stand, I see my auntie like trying to, she coming out from her room slowly, and then she rests on her door. But I myself is more on the little boy, because I'm there like a mother too, because everywhere I go with Kentrell. So when I reach by my auntie door, like I started, because when I shot a thing from his head, they shot him from the head and the body part when he was down on his. I just started, I came back, I ran to the kitchen and I started making noise, and my cousin and them started coming out. They were taking phone calling that one. I tried calling the police officers several times. I only got through from the before fire service, where the fireman took my everything and he told me he will call them, but they cannot assist without the police there. And that was it.
Tara Joseph would have previously vacated a home in light of the upsurge in gun violence in the area. And moments after her return with plans to go to church the following Sunday, she and her 2-year-old grandson met their untimely demise.
During the course of the incident that happened, the shootings that happened at the Viewfort Fisheries, Clark Street, Bruceville, 3 days after, it was a Friday morning around 1:45, where they break and enter that same house. They used that window, her room window, she was not there. And I was the one there, and her son, the same one I told her. It was the only two of us that was there when they break and enter. They thought they didn't have anybody there. So apparently, that happened. Okay, everything calm, police involved and everything. So during a shooting that Saturday, same Saturday that stuff happened to my aunt, there was a shooting before. Yeah. So and then they came and do what they do there.
Relatives of Tara Joseph and Kentrell Joseph say they will be sorely missed and are calling for justice for their loved ones, as well as an end to the spate of gun violence being perpetuated on the island.
Oh, I'm feeling so, so bad. I'm taking it so hard. Yeah, for Kentrell, because like I tell you all, I was there like a mother to Kentrell, just like his father. I was doing everything. When his father was in trouble, I was going all out for his father. Every time I go to work in the fisheries, sometimes I bring him and I have to bring him back when his grandmother comes because he's very troublesome. Because remember, that's a fishing complex. I don't want him to jump in the seawater.
Right now, it's just a tough situation. Just unbelievable. Well, the family is shocked. Like, we just never expected anything like that. When we fought everything before that calmed down, it just unbelievable experience. Everybody have to come together to stop it. Everybody, it cannot continue. When I thought the last of it was about a month ago, and for it to come back, it's just unacceptable. And we, the people of St. Lucia, Vivotians in particular, we need to come together. We not just come together, not just words, but action. We need to change our perspective on life. We need to change our perspective on how we care for our relatives, our friends, our community.
The death of the infant has been met with shock by St. Lucians, who have taken to social media to voice their frustrations with the ongoing violence. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.